Well, Bob, the weekend is upon us. Father's Day weekend as well. A lot of people probably heading to the beach despite all that red tide.
Yeah, and it's not a lot. It's patchy. And okay. In fact, I have a captain, Scott Moore, mm-hmm. who's been doing the waters and fishing the waters for 40 years up in Manatee County. And he called me up and said he's taking his boat up through Sarasota Bay and no problems throughout
good.
Much of central and northern portions of Sarasota Bay through Manatee County. Things are looking pretty good as far as that goes. Now, as pictures go, we're now looking at the first alert weather, as you can see. That first alert weather, nice photo sent in, and it looks like we will continue to see beautiful sunsets over the weekend. Fred Seeger sending this one in from Casey Key. Casey Key getting that shot, and it looks as though we'll see again another one, nice one tomorrow. So thanks for that, Fred. And another one from University, and this one from Sharkies. Sharkies showing a nice picture right there. Well, here's the radar picture in review, and it showed a lot of big storms around earlier today in Central Florida and along the East Coast, but not much going on now. We noticed quite a bit of rainfall, though, setting up in the Gulf of Mexico, and that's all associated with some upper air, little turbulence there, if you will, causing those showers to develop. We're still under the influence of a large dome of high pressure, and that high pressure ridge will continue to kind of dominate our weather right through the weekend. Now, winds will stay very light, so if you plan on boating, don't expect much wave action out there. In fact, things will be pretty smooth going throughout the bay and throughout the Gulf of Mexico, well out on offshore. A lot of rain inland today, and as it has been for the past week now, the inland areas have been getting hammered with heavy rainfall. Not much, though, going on near the coast. So we're in a summer pattern of sorts, but it's an unusual summer pattern. We see this happen during the mid part of the summer, too, when a high pressure kind of gets bumped right over the top of us, and we don't get that east wind to bring us those storms from the central part of the state over to the west coast in the evening and afternoon. Well, this is looking a little impressive, a little circulation here in the mid-levels of the atmosphere. It's nothing to be too concerned about. The Hurricane Center only gives it a 10% chance of developing, and if it were to develop, it would move off to the northwest. One thing to note, though, this is the same area that Alberto formed. Alberta, developed here in the Western Caribbean and eventually had an impact on our weather. This means we could maybe see a pattern here in the Western Caribbean for the first part of the season. So we'll have to keep an eye on that throughout the month of July, especially. Well, futurecast indicating not much rain for us throughout the morning, and we'll see a few showers possible in the late morning, early afternoon. Then most of the action will be inland, similar to what we've seen this whole week. That's going to continue on into Sunday, too. But on Sunday, we'll have a better chance for some of these storms to work their way back toward the coast in the late afternoon and especially in the evening. So rain chance is a little higher on Sunday, but nothing to worry about. I don't think you can cancel any of your plans if they're outdoors. Temperatures now across the state in the 70s, upper 70s right now. That's about our low tomorrow. It's going to start off warm and muggy here along the Sun Coast. Temperatures currently into the upper 70s to 80 degrees in downtown Sarasota. Look at the water temperature, warmed up to 87 degrees now, and that's pretty much where it stays throughout the next several months. 79 currently, and winds are out of the east-southeast at 8 miles an hour. The high today was warm, 90. It felt much warmer, though, with that higher humidity, around 97 degrees this afternoon. The forecast does call for a chance for a few morning showers, and then as that sea breeze moves in, there could even be a few isolated showers midday. Then most of the activity well inland throughout the afternoon and evening. Well, the forecast looks like this for boaters tomorrow. Smooth sailing out there. Seas running less than 2 feet, really. And looks like similar conditions on Sunday. The 7-day forecast then shapes up to be a warm one all the way through the next 7 days. You'll notice the rain chances bumping up a little bit on Father's Day, but it looks to be a pretty good Father's Day. High temperatures will be a little bit above average, and we'll see slightly drier conditions beginning Tuesday as those rain chances go down a little bit due to some drier air that will filter in across the Sun Coast. But all you fathers, enjoy your Father's Day weekend, I call it. Jacqueline, back to you.
All right, thank you, Bob.